Today's Hit Music 92 Pro FM. It's Davey and Barbi Jo in this afternoon, and we have a special guest joining us in studio. Hailee Steinfeld, welcome to the radio station.
Thank you so much.
Woo! Very exciting, your tour passing through our area, Mohegan Sun tonight, and another show coming up over the weekend in Boston. How's the tour been?
The tour's been amazing. I really can't believe it's like coming to an end. It's been one of the best experiences ever, and I've been loving every second of it.
How long have you been on tour, total?
We
should say you're on tour right now with Meghan Trainor.
Yes, the Untouchable tour with Meghan Trainor. It's been about, oh my God, I have no sense of time, guys. How long has it been?
Well, let's see. We're in September.
Yes.
So was it most of the summer?
Yes.
Okay. And is it coming to an end soon?
It is. Boston, we end in M-Train's hometown. So.
Wow. I love what you call her, the M-Train.
Yes.
Honey, you're on the M-Train right now. What do they call, if they call her fans Megatrons, I heard, do they call your fans Hazers?
There have been a couple names thrown around. Steinfans was one of them. Hazers, Hazies, there's a bunch of different.
How are the fans responding to you on tour?
It's been overwhelming. I mean, I guess seeing how Megan's fans, how I can find a connection with them. And Megan and I have a lot in common, especially with our music, with our sort of self-empowering messages, going out there and making a connection with people and talking to people about experiences where in the moment we felt like we were the only ones, but there are thousands of people we get to look out to every night that have gone through the same thing. So it's been amazing finding the connection with all of them.
You know, you've got a lot of projects, you know, in the works. You got a new movie coming out with Woody Harrelson called Edge of 17. That must have been really exciting to work with Woody and making a movie. Did this all happen while you were on tour? Did you have to come off dates and do some acting then come back?
Or? No, luckily I was able to focus on the movie at the time. I did release my EP when I was making the movie, so it'll be a year ago in November, which is crazy. So yeah, a year ago I shot the film, and Woody is the best person ever. I mean, to work with, to hang out with, to know, he's just an amazing human being. So I had a great time making this movie, and I really can't wait for you to
see the trailer. It really looks fun.
Thank you.
Like coming of age kind of thing.
Totally.
Totally. It comes out November?
November 18th.
Now, coincidence, were you 17 while filming this movie?
I was 18, actually.
That's all right.
Not too far off.
If it all came together, it would have been so good. What's it like dividing your time between music and acting?
It presents a lot of challenges quite often, actually. But to be honest, I find myself feeling so incredibly blessed to be able to do both and have the opportunity to do both. Again, you know, some of the times they'll coincide and it becomes a bit of a struggle, but it works. We make it work.
I like looking at a lot of your photos when you're backstage. Instagram, you know, you post a ton of things up on Instagram, and you know, you being a little goofy backstage, but being you, right? I mean, this is just everything we see. It's my feeling is like, this is a real deal. This is really her being, you know, dancing around like that.
Totally.
And 250,000 people end up liking it.
Right.
That's crazy.
It is crazy. It is.
It's funny. I was in New York recently in Times Square, and I look up and I see a billboard for American Eagle.
Woo!
And I think to myself, I'm like, is that Hailee Steinfeld? And I wasn't sure. And then I noticed you posted something about it, and I'm like, oh, she's a part of the new campaign. Congratulations.
Yes. Thank you so much. I'm so excited to be a part of this campaign with American Eagle. They're completely revamping everything about the brand, and I'm honored to be, again, a part of it. I was in New York. We played Radio City there, and, you know, happened to be driving through Times Square on my way back to the hotel and, like, looked out the window and, like, oh, my God, I freaked. It was amazing.
Did you know it was, like, up, and you're like, here it comes, here it comes.
I heard that it was up, right? But we're going through, and it was, like, a completely different, you know, thing going on that specific billboard, and we're looking around, and all of a sudden it, like, starts, and we're like, oh, my God. And then before you know it, it's, like, on a loop, and we're like, okay, everybody get their cameras ready this time.
Have you ever been to Rhode Island before?
Yes, I have.
You have, have you?
I have.
Yeah. Oh, it's funny you mentioned that, Davey.
I didn't know. I don't know what she's going to ask you, but I just had a feeling that you've been here before.
Listen, everybody knows that you're part of the Taylor Swift squad. You know? So how does one become certified and be a part of the squad? Because I've been trying for a long time.
Does someone have to go through training?
There is a branding process that we all go through. Nobody ever really talks about it, though, because it's more of a, I'm getting myself in trouble here. Right. No, there is really no kind of initiation anything. I've known Taylor for years, and it's been amazing sort of, you know, all coming together and banding together and becoming, you know.
One of the reasons why I was at a 4th of July party at the same exact time, and then everything's at the party, people's phones were blowing up. So simultaneously, while there was a celebration going on where you were, a lot of people were celebrating 4th of July. They're like, did you know that Taylor's throwing a big party? Look at all the people that are going to be there.
It was
exciting, you know. We don't live in a huge state. It's not New York City, and it's not, you know, Los Angeles, where celebrities and stars come in and out. So it's nice to hear that, you know, you got to visit us and you know, have a little bit of fun on the water. It's a nice place.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Hey, I got to, for a minute, got to see the performance that you did on Seth Meyers. Knocking it out of the park. That was great.
Thank you so much.
You know, a lot of artists right now, especially, are leaning towards working with EDM DJs. You know, you see DJ Snake working with Bieber and Major Lazer, with the 10 DJs that are in Major Lazer. You know, you got to work on Starving with Zedd.
Yes.
How does that come about? Do you collaborate with him, or people say, I think Hailee should go with Zedd?
Well, funny enough, so Zedd and I met a while back, and we exchanged information and been talking about collaborating, and finding the time and the place, being in the same place at the same time, was like the number one thing that was like, you know, working against us. But finally we happened to be in the same place. He sent me a message saying that I have this track, you've got to hear it. And this was like, I mean, a year into talking about collaborating. And there was even a fan that like tweeted at him once and was like, you should collaborate with Hailee. And he's like, ooh, good idea. And I was like, screenshot. and he sent me this message, and I happened to be literally within walking distance of the studio that he was working out of. And I made my way over to him as soon as I could. Listened to this track within 24 hours, cut the record, you know, met Gray, and showed it to the label, and that's how it came
about. Wow, that's great. She's got a song on the radio, a new movie coming out. Hailee Steinfeld is with us on Pro FM.
So we do something here at Pro FM. Mm-hmm. It's called the Fast Five.
Okay.
So I'm going to give you two options, and simply enough, you just got to pick one.
Okay.
All right, can you handle that?
I think so.
All right, here we go. Starving or hangry?
Starving.
I mean, hanger is a real thing.
It is a real thing.
In my world. Phone selfie or Polaroid selfie?
Ooh, Polaroid selfie.
I heard you have a thing with Polaroids.
I do. I love.
Grammys or Oscars?
Groskers.
Groskers.
The Groskers. That's my favorite award show.
We've never had someone mishmash the words together. Very nice.
Brilliant. Snapchat or Instagram?
Oh my God! Well, I would normally always say Snapchat, but with this Instagram story Snapchat thing, I kind of love it.
Okay, Manny or a Petty?
Manny.
Okay.
Ah, excellent.
Done.
That is great.
You
nice
just killed
job.
It at the Fast Five.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Simple as that.
Well, Hailee, congratulations on all the luck. You got a great song on the radio, climbing the charts.
Thank
a new
you.
Movie coming out.
Yes.
On tour, wrapping up, and you're gonna. I'm sure you're not gonna. Rest.
No.
So 2016 will be busy. 2017. Congratulations on all the success, and thank you for coming by.
Of course. Thank you so much. By the way.